When do you think it started, Fez?
Washington's 106.7 WJFK. Here starts Ron and Fez.
Okay, good. You're in for that, right?
Ron and Fez.
All right, we're going to take a break here, Fez. We'll be right back in a few moments. Why don't we come back in before we get into the hypnotist stuff? We'll have the debut of Billy Staples' brand new video with Incubus, and it's called Talk Show on Mute. Talk Show on Mute.
I can't wait. I've been waiting for this debut.
Yeah, I saw some still pictures, so I knew what he looked like. I didn't want to ruin that for you.
I actually got an email from him today trying to send it to me, yeah. And I didn't look at a thing.
Yeah.
He said, I am going to wait for the on-air premiere.
All right, we'll be right back. It's the Ron and Fez Show. All right, this is the part of the show where we debut brand new videos, Fezzy. Right?
I love
this. Yeah, we never do it before, but we have to this time because our own Billy Staples is in an Incubus video. Now, this is going to be big, right, Dub? You say these guys always get a lot of MTV play.
Oh, yeah, they get all over the place. Radio, MTV, the video should be on the box. Mm-hmm. It's a great thing.
All right, you guys have got a link up on ronfez.net. Billy Staples with us for many years. A lot of go to LA, Fez, he obtained fame and fortune, and let face work out for him. I mean, he was out there for only a couple of weeks, and he's already doing a video.
Yeah, the Incubus, I guess they saw him, just had to have him.
Yeah. Well, he's also with Zeph Grinke, and you know that's what it's all about.
Grinke manager.
Yeah. By the way, Alan was telling us that we have a good agent. I go, he's your agent, Alan, not ours.
Yes, Alan loves them.
I get the angle. All right, let's take a look at this. This is a Talk Show on Mute, starring Billy Staples and featuring Incubus. Are you excited for this, Fez?
I can't wait.
Yeah. I'm trying to get the whole thing on the air.
Who knows?
Okay, all you dogs and kings and wild animals of the world, here they are, finally, the one who was waiting for, Incubus!
All right, that was Billy Staples, Fez.
That was Billy?
Yeah, that was Billy Staples, and he's in some kind of, I guess, hyena costume. Did you notice that part?
Yes! That's Billy!
Billy says, all right, do you know the guy who did the Planet of the Apes stuff, Rick Baker? And I go, yeah, Rick Baker, the famous makeup artist. He goes, my stuff was done by some of his pupils. I go, oh, okay. I thought he was
from Baker school.
I thought he was going to say Rick Baker did this stuff. All right, so that's Billy. He's dressed up as, I guess, a hyena, but he's also a talk show host, and he's talking funny and crazy. So we'll play it one more time, and then we'll get into the song. So he's excited about this, but he is a hyena.
I thought it was going to lead to some things, but he's, unless it's more hyena work, I'm not sure. If he did that voice on our show, we'd send him out of the room.
So for some reason, Billy is a hyena that runs a talk show that's run by, like, animals. But here comes Incubus, and they're like 60s mod.
Yeah, they're human.
Yeah, they're human, and the audience is human for some reason.
Take a bow.
And big cats are dancing behind them as dancers.
It's really creepy looking.
Yeah.
The animal people.
There's Billy dressed as whatever he is, getting makeup work done. So you would not know him.
Yeah, is this all...
This is all Billy.
That's all Billy as that character.
Yeah. There he is running like a hyena.
Oh, that looked like Billy. That was Billy's walk.
Well, that is Billy.
That was a very Billy thing that creature did.
So, for whatever reason, Incubus is playing this talking animal show, and Billy seems to be a bad person as a talk show host for some reason. He's not like a nice one. He's like an evil animal talk show host.
Yeah, the adult-sized cats and 90s are freaking me out.
And there's chimpanzees at home watching. Those are real chimpanzees. Different animals watching their TV.
That looks like real penguins.
So I think this is going to lead places for Billy.
I hope so. Like the cat people, they walk normal and they dance like go-go dancers.
Yeah.
But Billy actually does an animal walk in this.
Smart. Smart.
I don't know if he was supposed to.
Well, he's in character.
Because all the other animals are acting human.
Now, admit this. This is a pretty good little song.
There's Billy.
There's Billy just acting the crazy hyena. He said he was 4.5 hours in and out of makeup.
There's Billy and a goat.
Go to RonFez.net to see Billy Staples and his big show, Talk Show Mute. Still dancing monkeys.
The monkey's like, there's Billy.
Billy's all over this thing, but you don't know that it's Billy because he's in a hyena costume.
So he's the one with the microphone, like, as the MC animal.
Right.
There's a cameraman that looks like Lassie.
All right, now somebody came in wearing a mask, and they're trying to disrupt it. And you notice it's a human wearing an animal mask. Billy's freaking out, and he's looking around. Billy just turned into Billy, and he's screaming.
Look at Billy. They took the makeup off of him, and he's hideous.
He's screaming for some reason that he's turned human. And I don't know how turning the lights off turns... And now the animals watching are upset. But I don't know why if somebody messing with your electricity turns you from hyena to human.
Yeah, they turned off the lights on the Wonder
There's
State.
Billy. He can't stand it. He's overacting. Petrified.
Because there's no fur on his face. He doesn't know what to do. The monkey's trying to adjust his set, looking at Billy's face.
All right, the cats haven't changed. Only Billy's the only one turned into a human. There's Billy kind of blank screaming, trying to get this together. Well, let's face it, he was phenomenal.
All right, Billy Staples and the new Incubus video.
Now, I don't exactly know what the point of the video was. Like, be careful or one day you'll turn from a hyena to human. I think that's there. Or does Billy represent society?
The jackal that is society?
I.e. an Orwellian society. Because they were singing about 1984, but then it was more of a deal of, at the end, he was Billy again, but he wasn't happy with it.
Yeah, and he never got around to liking his new look. He was still screaming. That little test tone you heard at the end was coming out of Billy's mouth.
All right, we're trying to get Billy up now, but I'll say this for him. He sold it the whole way. He sold it as the hyena host, and he sold it as the human at the end screaming. Now what we got to hope for is that this thing is a big enough hit that he's the B-girl of this generation.
Oh, nice. If there's like some MTV Video Music Award.
Yeah, where he can show up and be the hyena host who turns into a human over and over. People go crazy for him. We got him on right now. It is the star, Fezzy. You'll know him also by this.
Okay, all you dogs and kings and wild animals of the world, here they are, finally, the one who was waiting for, Incubus!
There's the star of the new Incubus video. It's Billy Staples. How you doing, Billy?
Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
Oh, geez. Listen to him. He's calling his gentleman, Fezzy. He's already living life at the top.
Yes, I don't have much time. I'm off to a star party tonight, so...
Is that right?
Got a couple minutes for you guys.
With the cat girls, the fancy cat girls?
Cats in 90s.
If you would have seen what those cat girls looked like without the make... They were like three, like, almost like supermodels.
Yeah?
oh, sweet God in heaven. No. I saw them, like, getting changed and stuff. That was, like, the best part of the video.
You animal.
Now, Billy, why did you... What kind of animal were you?
I was a hyena.
That's what I was thinking. Now, why did you turn human, and why did that make you so upset?
Well, because it's based on Animal Farm in 1984. Like, you just...
Right.
You nailed it on the head, where the animals have actually taken over from the humans.
Right.
And
then in their world, like, we have animals play instruments, and we watch... No, wait, that doesn't work. Okay, no.
It's
so,
like animals are our pets, and then they're humans are our pets.
Right.
The humans are there for our amusement.
Right.
So, Incubus was your pet.
Yeah. Incubus was part of the pet as well,
like
as the other dancing people.
Like they were the banana splits, I guess.
Yeah, pretty
to
much.
To us.
Yeah, that's why they had them. We transported them in by, they were all in chains, and the girls had to drag them out on stage.
Okay, so what we're saying is a vegan lifestyle would be a better way. Us as humans, we're on top now, but it's not going to stay that way, Fez.
No.
But don't hyenas eat meat?
Yes, but not as much as we eat, and they don't cook it.
See, the hard thing
don't
is...
Don't ruin this, Fez, okay? Go ahead.
I was the head of the animals, being the top.
Oh, you're like the president.
Yeah. And the fact that when I turned back into a human, I was one of the scum of the earth.
So you,
shall we say?
So you were a human before you were a hyena?
No, for some reason, the flicking of the lights off, and through a turn of events, I turned into the old. It was so vintage werewolf movie style.
Right.
Remember, of like the transformation. That transformation, that 5 seconds took 4.5 hours to do.
Why you kept messing up?
No, because you notice the difference, it was like 4 different masks. It's not like Mission Impossible, where those masks just peel off like all of a sudden Tom Cruise is John Voight.
Here's what I don't understand. In Animal Farm, the pigs became humans. You should have been a pig talk show host.
Yeah, but you know what? The pigs did become... They had a pig as the sound man, which you really didn't see much. But the hyena was like more of a character with the laugh and to make fun of the band. You know, because as you heard in the beginning, that was me. Yeah,
right.
With the laugh.
You did great.
Stuff.
Yeah, we got this right here. Let me say, we're going to use this now. We've got all your real drops together from your last TV work. All right, so that's good work there, Fezzy. I mean, he's in character.
Yeah, did they have to coach on that voice, or is that what you gave them?
Actually, I went for the audition, and the next day were callbacks, and I never heard, and I was very upset. And then they called me at 7 o'clock at night and said, you know, you booked it. We're not even having callbacks.
Wow.
Yeah, so they were, I was exactly what they were looking for with the laugh and everything, so... And then we shot it, and now it's not officially released yet, but like you said, with MTV, let's get this thing a TRL role, and let's make me the next B-girl.
I would love for you to be the B-girl for this generation, and just get out there. You're doing different things as the hyena talk show host. Or are you stuck as a man now?
I'm sorry?
Are you stuck as a man now, since at the end you were at a man?
They need to turn the lights back on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the light switch and, you know, me, actually I was screaming my bloody head off at the end, but they didn't have it. But the thing I love about the video, the actual shape of the video is the TV screen, because it's a 60s vibe, like a Hugabaloo or whatever.
Yeah, it had like a mod, like a mid-60s things going
on. So your music career stretches from Hugabaloo to Incubus.
Pretty
He's
much,
He's done
yeah.
it all. Now, Billy, you said you were hanging out with Jared Leto that day, right?
Yeah, I have a picture of him, me and Jared Leto together.
Was he in the video?
No, he's just a good friend of the band.
Oh, I see. Okay.
He's a good friend. He came down and
supported
hung out for a while.
Yeah.
And then, so I had a picture taken with me in full makeup as with Jared Leto. Because I said, if I don't get a picture with you, my daughter will kill me. Because she loves him.
Is that right?
So that way she can show it to the friends and say, the hyena on the left is my dad.
And it looks nothing like me. It could be anybody in that makeup. Yeah, Christy, that's me. I swear
yeah,
to God.
No I know.
Problem.
That's why I'm glad that you had that scene at the end.
Yeah.
So people couldn't say, that's not you doing the hyena talk show host.
Meanwhile, the pig man was all upset. He goes, how did you get that role? And I'm only the sound guy.
So he really did talk like a pig. All right,
that's
now,
jealousy in the animal kingdom.
Are you getting a lot of feedback yet, or are you going to wait for it?
Yeah, it's actually, if you go to a couple of the websites, like enjoyincubus.com and there's a few others, there's like the message boards are like full now of talk about it. It has not been released. It's not going to be released, I believe, until May 24th on MTV and the other music channels.
Yeah.
But this is just on the Epic Records site where people can get a preview of it and like get a little buzz going for it because the single gets released May 24th.
Hey, by the way, I think the song's good. I think the song sounds like a hit.
It very
smells like Teen Spirit. Yeah.
Very pop. Very pop, which is different for Incubus.
Very hullabaloo. Let's face it. It's very hullabaloo.
I agree with you.
I can't wait to be watching MTV where it's that brand spanking new video and they're peeling the wrapper off.
The buzz. I want to be on the buzz.
All right.
Hey, listen, me and Carson Daly are going to hook up when I get back to New York.
You better go Ryan Seacrest on the other coast. He seems to have all the heat right now. Billy, you shook me and Fez off like a couple of losers, and there you are, starring on the West Coast. Anything you want to say to your fans, buddy?
Listen, I'd just like to thank Cameron.
Oh, stop it.
No,
just stop it.
I miss all you guys out there tremendously, and I just hope that I know I saw that Jeff already posted it on the ronfez.net, which is pretty cool.
Yes.
I appreciate it. I'd like to thank him for doing that.
You sent it to me today, and so many other people did, too. Everybody's all excited for you.
Yeah, I thank you guys immensely, too. Of course, you know, you kind of...
We treated you like
that. Gave me the confidence. You know, this is a different Billy Staples now.
We used
great.
To kick you out for laughing like that.
Yeah. All right, Billy.
Guys, thanks again. Thanks to all the listeners in D.C. and New York, you know, for standing by me through all my hard times. And now let's hope and enjoy my success a little bit.
Bring up the orchestra music because we got to play them all. This is what you play. You practice it for MTV Video Awards?
Frank Conti, get him off the stage.
Put it this way. The guy who, hey, what's up there, Igor? the guy who did my makeup.
Yeah.
The actually has already won some VMAs.
Is that right? So could be going all the way, huh?
Tammy Faye Baker.
No. His name is Screamin' George.
Screamin' George. Let's face it. You don't see that kind of makeup work normally in a regular video.
No, he's already won VMAs for makeup.
All right, Billy. We'll talk to you later.
Hey, I'll see you at the VMAs in Miami.
All right, we'll see you there, Billy. There you go.
Billy in Miami. That's a good combo.
The Days of Lines and Noses is what he's going to call his book.
I want to thank everyone who helped me through my hard times. We all pointed and laughed.
Yeah.
Your hard times were our good times.
We didn't help you through your hard times. We were your hard times. Fezzy, you got to give it to the kid. He went out there on his own, said, I'm going to make it. And in no time at all, he finds himself in a video. If he could do that, you don't think he could get some kind of a hyena movie?
Hyena, a B-girl and hyena boy. I'd like to see it.
I don't know. I watch television. I watch movies. I'm not seeing, okay, Nicholson, I'm impressed. You know, Bob De Niro, I'm impressed. I see a lot of other bums in those movies, though, that are no better than Billy.
Billy, huge part in this video.
He owns it.
He is all through it, and you get to see his human face. That's the one that comes at the end.
Are you still being mean?
No. I'm happy for Billy.
Howard Stern, Don and Mike, Bill O'Reilly, Ron and Fez, and the Washington Redskins. 106.7 WJFK.